When we talk about biomedical concepts, we must first define what they are. For me, they are protocol building blocks that contain all necessary information start to end, meaning from protocol writing to regulatory submission. In our talks, for example, we do already have biomedical concepts published, but unfortunately not in a machine-readable way. Here is an example of a very simple biomedical concept, blood pressure. As one sees, it contains SDTM information as well as control terminology information. It does, however, not contain any information about how data can be extracted from EHRs, but it does enable to set up electronic case report forms. Biomedical concepts are, however, not an invention of CDISC. Such concepts are already known for a long time in the world of healthcare. OpenEHR, as it archetypes, HL7 FHIR has its profiles, and if one thinks about it, a LOINC panel is very similar to a CDISC biomedical concept. What is LOINC? Most of us know it as a burden, since the FDA requires to deliver the LOINC code for lab tests. But LOINC is much, much more. Also for clinical research is a huge opportunity. LOINC is about tests, whether lab or microbiology tests, vital sign tests, but also questionnaires and other standardized forms. Many of these tests come with standardized answers, and for which the mappings with, for example, SNOMED CT is usually provided. For tests with quantitative results, all the highly recommended units are provided in the UCOM notation, which is much better than our own unit control terminology. As such, LOINC is a de facto standard for definition and description of any tests in the healthcare world. Here is an example description of the LOINC code for body height. It essentially contains everything we need to work as a biomedical concept, except for the mappings to SDTM. As such, I consider it as an incomplete BC. So, the question quickly arises whether one could generate biomedical concepts starting from LOINC codes in an automated way. This would enable us to generate BCs for which equivalents are already used in healthcare anyway. If we look at LOINC panels, which are logical groupings of related tests, like here, the blood pressure panel, we see that they look very much like BCs and are screaming for automated generation of BCs from them. So, we took the challenge. We have to take into account that there are over 4,300 LOINC panels, and we surely do not want to treat all of them. We also want to be able to store them in a machine-readable format, something that we haven't been trying to do within CDISC yet. And of course, we will need a way to visualize them for human consumption. For all of this, we do, however, need to have or develop LOINC to CDISC mappings. So, what do we need? First of all, we need a LOINC database. That is easy. We can just download it from the LOINC website. Then we need mappings. The by CDISC published LOINC to CDISC mappings only contain mappings for about 1,400 LOINC codes, which is far from sufficient, and then only for the LB domain. So we developed additional LOINC SDTM mappings, so that we now have over 9,500 mappings for LB, 600 mappings for vital signs, and very important at this moment, nearly 150 mappings for COVID-19 microbiology tests, still growing. S-LOINC, just like the entire healthcare world, uses UCOM notation for units, we also need the UCOM to CDISC unit mapping. It would, however, be much wiser when also CDISC switches to UCOM notation. And we made all of these available as a set of RESTful web services. But we will also need additional mappings between LOINC answers and CDISC CT, which we can get from the UMLS RESTful web services from the National Library of Medicine. UMLS stands for Unified Medical Language System. It tries to connect all coding systems used in the medical world, including CDISC CT. It has a RESTful web service available, allowing us to use it in any modern software. This allows us to find the relations between LOINC answers, SNOMED CT and CDISC controlled terminology. It is barely known within the clinical research community, and that is really a shame, as it can be extremely well used when dealing with real-world data within clinical research. We also need a machine-readable format for storing our generated biomedical concepts. For the moment, we decided to store our results as graphs and use RDF Turtle, but this may change in future. We also need a visualization tool for generating human-friendly representations of our generated BCs as graphs. We just selected one, but essentially any graph visualization software can be used. And then we still need to write the software. Okay, let's do a short demo.
We will generate a prototype C-disc biomedical concept for the panel code 350959, body temperature panel. It is asked whether we also want to generate the SNOMED CT codes. We need to take into account that some parts need to be split into VS-LAT and VS-LOC. The system immediately starts creating the biomedical concepts. The system doesn't recognize the code for body temperature measurement site as it was not part of the low-ink C-disc mapping. We however know it must go into VS-LOC. The system now starts mapping the low-ink answers to C-disc controlled terminology and SNOMED codes. It does so using the UMLS RESTful web services provided by the National Library of Medicine. This takes a little bit of time, as the UMLS RESTful web service is not very fast. Also, the code for body temperature device class is not recognized. We will put it in a supplemental qualifier variable. The same applies to body temperature device inventory number. And 2, body temperature device model number. And similarly, 4, body temperature device serial number. The alternative would have been to skip such items. The prototype biomedical concept has been generated. The biomedical concept is then written into a machine-readable Turtle RDF file. This will later enable visualization, but also querying, or extending or adapting the biomedical concept. It will also allow to automate the generation of data capture tools, such as electronic case report forms.
You can find all the results that we generated so far at this website. The number of them is still growing. Each of the results is available in RDF Turtle format, as well as a PDF with a human understandable visual graph. As said, however, you can just take the Turtle file and use your own visualization software. Some of the results come with SNOMED CT codings, which is especially important when generating C-disc datasets starting from electronic health records. You will find the results for lab tests, vital signs, and COVID-19 microbiology panels and tests. Here is a simple example for body height. Starting from the loin coat, the BC is generated including the possible units and the mappings to SDTM. Most results are however more complex, but they are machine readable, so that they can be used in many ways. How can we use these machine readable BCs? Having them in a machine readable form allows us to automatically generate SDTM annotated case report forms. For example, in ODM format, and this is something we already tried out. We can also query them, breaking complicated graphs into subgraphs. We can also combine such graphs, for example, to make so-called supergraphs. And we can of course generate different visualizations. Why did we also include SNOMED CT in our generated biomedical concepts? The answer is very simple. As we want to use our BCs to retrieve information from electronic health records and even fully automatically generate SDTM datasets from them. We need to take into account that EHRs never heard about CDISC controlled terminology, but they do know SNOMED CT very well. In our opinion, CDISC and the clinical research community should pay much more attention to SNOMED CT. There is, however, still a lot to do. We need to align with the work of A3 Informatics that has just started and that Dave will be talking about later today. Within CDISC, we need to agree on the machine-readable format used to store and publish machine-readable concepts. And of course, we also need to agree on how we name objects and relationships between them. We already have started using our generated BCs in work with real-world data, but that is still in a very early stage. We are also steadily extending the LOING to CDISC mappings. For example, we also started generating mappings for the EG domain, but soon found out that a lot of CDISC-controlled terminology is still missing. And we are currently starting working on questionnaires, which is very exciting, but also might be very challenging. And we want to extend the work to LOING nested panels. Also, it is not understandable at all for us why SNOMED CT and LOING coding is still kept out of talks. For example, the interim COVID-19 guide does not even contain the SNOMED CT codes for the disease. Special thanks for encouraging the current work, and many good discussions go to Dave, Kirsten and Johannes, to Erin, Tim, Sam and to Peter. Many thanks.